friends. It's your old pal, Jordan the Lion. How are you all doing today? I hope you said well. I'm doing great. We are gonna have a blast today. Today we are in Miami, and we are gonna do a little bit of sightseeing. We're gonna hit a Marlins game, and who knows what else. Daze with Jordan the Lion, it begins right now. Maybe one of the all-time best murals you can ever find. Washington Avenue, they're showing Jackie Gleason. Over here you got Muhammad Ali because of the Fifth Avenue boxing gym. Look at all this over here. That is awesome. Speaking of the boxing gym, I want to go see that. That's only a few blocks away. Oh, it looks like up here they even call it the Muhammad Ali Fifth Street Gym now. I didn't know that. I always just knew it as the Fifth Street Gym. And then over on this other side, you have Prince. That is awesome. With his favorite guitar. This is the same area where they filmed Ace Ventura. If it looks familiar to you. It's actually right up this alley. Really where Muhammad Ali's life changed. He had won the Olympic gold medal and came back to Louisville, his hometown, and a group of investors decided to help him go pro. And they contacted Angelo Dundee at this gym. And Angelo said, well, it'll take some time, but I'll work with him. Next thing you know, Ali's fighting Sonny Liston for the championship. How cool is this? Wow. Mind-blowing to see all this since I've been seeing so much Muhammad Ali stuff lately. His childhood home and fighter's heaven. Now to see this. Came down here is when he went to the barbershops and saw everybody talking smack and rhyming while doing it, so that became his thing. How cool. Muhammad Ali's gym. Back when he was Cassius Clay, look at that. So cool. There they have a picture of Muhammad Ali with the Beatles, punching the Beatles, and that took place here in this gym. All right, now we're gonna head off to the Marlins game. So cool. All right, we are going to my first Marlins game tonight, and have no fear with the rain coming because they have a retractable roof. I normally try and walk around the outside, but because of how bad the rain has been over the last 2 hours, I'm just gonna go on in, and maybe we'll check the outsides out when we get done. So I usually use the little steadying handle, but they won't allow them in today. So if it's less stable than usual, that's why. And for future vloggers, just know you can't bring it in. They'll send you back to your car. It's cool to be here. I remember when they first became a franchise. As an elementary school, my friends, we all got into liking the Marlins because we were just excited there was a new set of teams. So I actually wanted to get like seats in the outfield tonight, and then when I went online to buy them, I noticed that only the front row is sold. The attendance is so bad here that nobody is sitting anywhere beyond the front row. So I figured, well, if I want to go sit there, I can. I'll just buy really good seats so I have them, and then if I want to go to the outfield, I'll know that there's plenty of available space. Weird to enter the park and then immediately get on the escalator. Never had to do that anywhere before yet. Kind of dumped us out over here in left field. I was originally looking at seats right over there, and like I said, just the front row. Those are the only seats that were sold. There's hardly anything even as far as seating in the center field. So I ended up getting seats right on the dugout over here, and like I said, we can just go wander back there if we want to later. Of course, we gotta hit a team store. I think I wanna hit one of the bigger ones. I wanna get a hat, of course. And here's some of the Orange Bowl history. It's kinda cool. Showing Super Bowl III, Jets upset the Colts. And over here they're showing a little bit of when Kennedy was here. It's kind of neat about the Marlins. When they were a young franchise, I mean, they were brand new. They actually won the World Series. It was kind of crazy. And then their owner made a lot of enemies because as soon as they won the World Series, he decided to sell off all the good players because he just didn't think they could do it again. And all the people that were trying to become fans got really upset about it. So they generally open the parks about 90 minutes before the game. So we're actually here about an hour before the game. And like I said, I've seen online they have really poor attendance, but they're actually on like kind of a winning streak right now. They've been playing really well, so should be a good game. And Strasburg is pitching for the Washington Nationals. Great pitcher, hasn't pitched for a long time. That should be good. Yeah, in fact, I think this is his Strasburg's return to baseball. Also kind of crazy to see so much Marlins team color stuff being red now. Let's go in this team store.
It's cool stuff, I'm not gonna lie. Cool logos. See, I actually had one of the original Florida Marlins fitted caps. I wish I still had it. I think probably what I'll get, since I always get one, get a hat for each stadium, I'll probably get that one. I don't know. I'm not sure if I wanna walk around with an M. But I do like that. I like the Marlin. See, there's some of the cool old Marlin stuff I remember when they were the Florida Marlins. 1993, that's great. Just different now, you know? Just a little bit different. I always love these player shirts. So the problem is they only have these in fitted with this like netting back, and those kind of make my head itch. I don't know if I wanna deal with that. Sugar Kings? They go by the Sugar Kings also? We are way down there. No batting practice today. All right, we are clubhouse box 21, seat 17, row A. We literally have zero people in front of us. We're right over the dugout. We'll see players with their heads popped up over here the whole game. This is going to be a great game. Where's all the historical stuff? They've had historical players and stuff. I mean, where are all the people? People! Here's a little bit, but I mean, that's Joe DiMaggio. He didn't play for the Marlins. I mean, what's all this about? I was also thinking, why don't they have any pictures of the players or anything? This is about the only thing I've seen. Wonder if they just get rid of players so quick they don't even think it's worth it. Hey, there's Jim Leland. Manager now is Don Mattingly. Let's get a view from the outfield where I was kind of thinking of getting our seats originally. They had two seats in the front row and nothing else had been sold. Maybe another time. It is fun watching a game from the outfield. You can see where every pitch ends up going into the strike zone from out here. I like that a lot. I'm just not, well, there's a bobblehead museum over here. Marlins bobblehead museum. Other than that, there's just not a whole lot of team history or anything here. It's not even all Marlins. These are, but, I mean, you're seeing Nationals down here. Pretty good sized museum though, right next to the kids playland area over here. If you're bored before the game. Looks like the rain's kinda laid off a little bit, luckily. Why do we have train tracks? What is that all about? Everybody's getting excited. Here's the scoreboard with two pennants above it, one from 1997 and one from 2003. So those escalators are the way that you access the higher seats up there, but I don't think they even have those open right now because of the attendance. There's the foul pole. All right, I didn't go in this team store yet. Let's try this one. They have a few more choices here. They have the black on black version. They have just one that says Miami. I saw somebody else wearing that one. It actually looks pretty good. I think I'm gonna go for that one after all.
You're probably saying to yourself, did you really absolutely have to get one? You have a ton of baseball hats already. It actually makes it more fun being here and rooting for the team when you're all part of it and everything. At some point I'll probably like do a Patreon thing where I send these out, but yeah, it actually makes it more fun getting to root for the home team and being a part of it all.
Yeah, I've been all the way around the park. I haven't seen any statues of any players or like the trophies or anything on display, so I wonder where that's all at.
I think I'm gonna get a Pincho dog, whatever that is. I saw somebody else walk away with one. It looks pretty good.
So that's what it is. I asked what's on it and they said potato skins, pineapple, and bacon. Interesting. Might try and throw, I don't know what your condiments you're supposed to put on there, if anything. I opted to put a little bit of mustard on there. That thing's actually really, really good. I recommend it.
That's just so strange to me. Look how much of center field doesn't have any seating. Like how many home run balls fans cannot get. That's usually like the fun of sitting out there is like, but there's no seating at all. I wonder why they did that. I'm not trying to be a jerk or anything, but I have to say this is like probably the worst park I've ever been to as far as like seeing historical stuff or anything like that, or even really any fans. Every other park is kind of decked out with team spirit, and this one really just doesn't have any.
All right, there's Billy the Marlin. Good to see him out here putting smiles on faces. All right, keeping it real.
Thank you so much.
Kind of strange to look out into left field and see the giant word hair club through the whole game. We'll have to get used to that.
We're about 15 minutes from game time. This place is a ghost town.
I'm really excited to see Strasburg come back.
Time to come up for the national anthem.
Billy's ready for action. See?
Doing a little bit of a light show as they announce the Marlins.
Prepping his bat. First pitch. His third base coach has been over there sending some signals to the runner. Down there with the blue sleeves. Got him. Oh. At least we have a runner on third now.
Yeah.
See?
The second. All right.
All right. Base hit. Two runs in. Yes, yes. Go to second. Yeah. 3-0 in the first inning. Woo.
I'm gonna go sit in the back for a while. He's got a pretty good job. They're doing an interview up here. Oh, foul. The whole park is empty. Not just this section, but the whole place basically.
Get a home run back here, it's all ours.
Awesome throwback, Jeff Conine. It's kind of cool, hadn't seen that yet. I don't want to jinx myself, but I have not attended a loss yet this year. Every game I've been to, the home team has won.
Double play. Where's the relief squad?
Look at that score. 3-2, I shouldn't have said anything.
All right, Jazz, run it out, Jazz. All right.
Nice punt.
Go, 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 go home, go home, go home! Yeah! Woo!
All right, 4-2 now. Back. That guy's got the Andre Dawson jersey on. That's awesome.
Yes! Get out. Oh.
People are mad. They think he was safe. Finally taking Strasburg out after all that. Pretty good looking score, 7-2.
Ooh. He was gonna charge the mound there for a second.
All right.
Walk it off.
Oh.
not good. Seventh inning stretch, they're up there, they're gonna dance around where my actual seat is if I would go back to it. Here go the Marlin Mermaids. Going. Not enough people in this place to do a wave. All right, eighth inning, and we're holding a pretty good lead, 7-4. All right, we're going into the bottom of the eighth. This hopefully will be our last bat. We'll win it after this. Alright, we got a light show because we're going into the ninth. I don't think they're going to blow it. I'm hoping they're not going to blow it, but 7-4, we should have a victory here.
Yes. Two down.
I'm undefeated this season, no matter where I go. Fins up. Welcome back, Steven Strasburg. How was that for a return? Woo!
Fantastic game, but kind of a boring stadium. Well, my friends, thank you for watching. If it's your first time here, please hit that like button, please subscribe, and please ring the bell for notifications. We'll see you all next time. Have a great night, and goodbye.